Hello, everyone. It's so nice to be here, and thank you all for joining me on this short presentation. So my name is Lisanne Dirks, and I work for Superused, and some of you might have to the talk of my colleague Jan Jongert, one of the founders of Superused Studios. We are an architecture and research studio from the Netherlands, based in Rotterdam. And I am trained as a product designer, actually, and I work for Superused as a designer, a researcher, and also as a trainer and facilitator. And in this context, I will give a workshop as well tomorrow. And today I will tell you about one of our tools. It's called the value system. And just for the ones who did not see the presentation, I will give a short introduction on what is the work of Superused, and that will also be the philosophy behind the value system game, so you will understand a little where this game, this tool came from. But at the moment, there's a huge waste flow there. And these materials have a lot of high qualities, such as durability, and they're really not easy to be damaged in use. And that's why we thought it was a good material to use in a playground. And we always try to use materials without processing them too much, so that the ecological benefit of reuse keeps valid and stays valid. And here, for example, we only cut the materials a couple of times, and we created some holes so that the children can play inside, and it becomes a very imaginative place site. Where I think we use the material to its best. And next project that I want to show is Buitenplaats Brienenoord. It's a cultural center that is fully developed with all of the stakeholders involved, even in the design process. And this has resulted in quite a special shape as well. And the way this was all developed in a workshop setting, where the stakeholders could build their favorite cultural center using the materials that were on site available from two Boy Scout buildings that would be demolished. And so all the materials there are come from these Boy Scout houses. And now it is a place where art, music, performance can be developed. It's a real experimental playground. And the next project, it's a bit of a different scale. It's the development of a circular economy hotspot, where different smaller or larger companies are situated that work on circular products, circular economy, and all of these companies together form what we call Blue City. And the unique thing is that we are the architect and co-initiator of this project, but we do not only how can we reuse as much reused materials in the development, in the transformation of this building. It used to be a swimming pool. But we also look at how all the smaller companies within this this building can reuse each other's waste flows. So it becomes more of a industrial symbiosis, an ecosystem on itself. as well the case with the next project. It's of a even bigger scale, Resource Valley. Huangpu is a development strategy for a place in an industrial area of Guangzhou, and it's going to be a circular business complex of 150,000 square meters. We do this project with our sister organization, Superuse. And here, as well as in the last project city that I showed you, the aim is to create an industrial symbiosis where companies are reusing each other's waste flows to go to a more sustainable economy. Now, I wanted to show you some of our work for the, to give you an idea of our way of thinking and going when we moved more towards consulting and training as a company as well, where we, when we started to help other project teams to apply the same philosophy. This is when we developed the value system game. And as you can see here, it is a card game where a team of people can lay down the different chains, production chain, value chains, to visualize the system that is in place in a company or in a project. And this is all, this is all pre-corona, so it's all live and everybody's very happily collaborating, and we haven't been able to do that very much in the last months, and that's why we did a digital version of this workshop in a program that is called Miro. This is also the program that I'm now using to give this presentation, and this is the program that we will be using tomorrow with the people that have subscribed to the Value System Game Workshop that I will be hosting tomorrow. So the next part of my talk, so the next 5 to 10 minutes will be about how does the value system game work in Miro, in the program Miro. To start with, we have we have different cards with different roles, let's say. So we have input cards on the left, which represent virgin resources such as water, let's say air or electricity. There's immaterial resources, and they go into a process, which are the middle cards. The process can be cutting, harvesting, baking, can also be selling something. And then transport is also a process, but it's quite distinctive and always used. So that's why we put it as a separate one. And then after a material entered, and it's after a material is entered, it goes also out of the system again, and as a product or service, as an end of life waste, or as waste as a resource. And we have some value tokens which can be placed in the system where most value is added or where most value is lost. So the next slide, you can see our worksheet. I will go out of presentation mode for a second so I can show you a bit more dynamic how that works. So for example, you can take a virgin resource card. This is our playboard for tomorrow as well. And you can write down something on it, like wood. And then you can take a process card. You take it, and then You can connect them with an arrow to show that wood is going into a sawmill, for example. And then you get a number of processes that you can connect to this, which I will show you later. But this is roughly how you play around with the different cards on the Miro work board. There's different steps in the game. There's actually three different steps, and I will walk through them one by one. And here you can see the first. And we're back. So I'm not sure what part I fell out. So I will just say that just a quick recap. Step one, you put down the process of a company or the process of a project with all the flows that go in and out of it and the whole chain. And step two, you identify the value, the most important value. Where is the most important value created? Have to specify it's not only monetary value, it's also ecological value or social value. And you show where most is getting lost, which is often where there's a lot of waste created or where there's a lot of inefficiencies. And in the third step, that's where you start to innovate. That's where you start to look for circular opportunities. So what we often do is we look at, hey, how can we replace all of the end-of-life waste cards with a blue card, which stands for waste as a resource. And for example, can we compost the agricultural waste to use it as a fertilizer, or can we use the coffee grounds? And this is a project that is all over the world quite famously nowadays. Can we use the coffee ground to grow mushrooms on it and use these mushrooms again for cooking of all sorts? And this is when a end-of-life waste flow becomes a new valuable resource. So with the value, this is actually the goal of the value system game, to create a new system with maybe multiple value flows that come out of one project or one company, and where waste is minimized and therefore where ecological benefits are created and also social benefits. So that's step. Now, during the game, if you need a bit of inspiration, there's always question cards. And these are the cards where you can ask, for example, how you can zoom into one and you can say, how could you collaborate with a local partner to create more value? Or you could ask yourself, is there ways to eliminate steps in the process to become more sustainable or to more circular? Or you could ask, sorry, I'm going to zoom in again, where might you be losing heat, energy, or heat that you can use more optimally for something else? So the question cards are more like, for inspiration when you get a bit stuck. But I will also, as a game host, help you further within the game, asking questions. So for tomorrow's workshop, we will be working on a fictional family house, And we will not only look at the building process, but we will also look at the use phase, and we will make flow diagrams as I showed you before, and showing which resources go in and out of the building. And we will optimize these flows and design and the design of the building using the super use approach. And this is it. This was the end of my presentation. So I hope to see some of you tomorrow during my workshop. And I hope that the value system game, the way of thinking and the way of visualizing resources has inspired you also to create more circular projects. Thank you very much.